Hi, now I'm going to show you how to move an iMovie project using a USB flash drive. First thing I'm going to do is just mount it to the desktop, and it'll appear as a disk icon. Then I'm going to open up iMovie, and there's a couple little interesting things about how iMovie works with disk drives. These type of drives are not fast enough to do the automated saving that we covered in the last tutorial. And so there's a little bit of a different process. So the next thing you need to know is that iMovie saves all of its movies in the user directory under movies. And so there's this folder, iMovie Events, and iMovie projects that are needed in order to migrate the project from one machine to another. So let's just go ahead and try this. I'm going to take the iMovie migration project and I'll save it to the USB flash drive, and then take the self-recording folder as well. Now I can eject that USB flash drive, and let's go and see if it works on a fresh machine. Now we're at the other machine, and I'm just going to place the thumb drive here in the USB port. It mounts to the desktop, and all I'm going to do is go in here and put these files in the correct place. So we'll get a new Finder window, Command N, and go to the Movies folder in the home directory, and you'll see I've got these two folders, iMovie Events and iMovie Projects, and they're both empty because I don't have anything on this particular computer. So I'll take the self-recording and just drag it into the Events folder. Remember, Events corresponds to the raw material, the video source. And then DMA migration is the project folder. And I'll copy that into the project folder. Close out those series of windows. And let's open up iMovie now and see if it recognizes the project and if it keeps it intact. So it does see the project, and if we open it up, let's see if it plays as it should. So it kept the music, the titles, the background overlay, the video from the other computer, the transition, so it kept everything. This is many more steps than the automated version using a higher speed USB or FireWire external drive. But in a pinch, this will work. And this is especially useful for when you have started with a blank slate. So if we go to the Finder into the Movies directory, if these two items, the self-recording, which corresponds to the DMA migration project, if that was the only thing that we had on this machine, what we could simply do is copy both of these folders and then paste that onto the USB flash drive, like so. Then in moving these two folders, to whichever machine we were interested in moving them to, provided we didn't want to overwrite what was already there. Like so, it would ask us, you know, do we want to replace this? Because those two folders already exist, and everything inside of them would be wiped out if you overrode the save. And this wouldn't be good if you had, you know, grandma's 75th birthday party and all your vacation videos on your machine. But if it's an InfoLab machine, which is blank every time it's re-imaged, this would be a fine way to do this. So you just say replace the other one. And you'd be good to go as far as editing your iMovie project on another machine. And there it is.